what it means to be a woman.
Now we have Laura in Montreal, Canada. Hello.
Hi.
Hello, Montreal, Canada. How you doing?
Hi. Fine. How are you?
Okay. Now what can I do for you?
I would like to know. I never dated. I'm 25 and...
You never dated, eh?
No. I'm still... I want to save myself and I want to just to be ready if I ever date. How do I tell the person that I want to save myself without offending him?
Why should it offend him, and who cares if it does?
Well, because I don't want him to know the wrong... It's for the wrong reason. Like, I'm putting him, like, he's after me for the wrong reason.
Oh, you have a suitor, do you?
Pardon?
You have someone pursuing you.
No, I just want to be ready if it ever happens. Like, because they told me, like, they might get offended if I tell them...
You mean your friends have told you that if you're not promiscuous, they might be offended. A person might be offended.
Yeah,
I would be offensive if I were you. I wouldn't bother about whether they're offended or not.
Okay, so I just tell them straight off that I want
to
save myself.
You don't have to tell them. It's body language mostly.
Okay.
You know what I mean? A woman has body language.
Mm-hmm.
And she lets a man know. You know, if you carry yourself, Laura,
yes,
with a lot of dignity, men will be afraid to approach you.
Oh, really?
You seem to me like you're trying so hard to be moral. Is that right?
I think so, yeah.
Maybe you're trying too hard. It should be natural in your soul.
Mm-hmm.
I think you're trying to sort of create a construction. You're sort of like huffing and puffing and worrying too much about it. I'd like you to be carefree and noble. If you would just learn to be dispassionate,
mm-hmm,
therefore not given to emotional fits and not being romantic and not being needing love from sensual love from the world, a different kind of energy will exude from you, a different kind of light. You send out different kinds of messages. A sensuous woman, an egocentric woman, a woman of the world who likes to play the awakened sensual feelings in men and make men hunger and gratify the hunger and take control and love the revel in the control that they gain, sends out a signal.
Okay.
Now, if, for instance, you take a Marilyn Monroe. I forget what her name was. What was her original name, Marilyn? You remember?
Norma Jean.
Norma Jean, yes. Well, there was Norma Jean, and then there was Marilyn Monroe. And Norma Jean, as a matter of fact, wasn't like Marilyn Monroe at all, because she was walking down the street as Norma Jean once, and she says to a friend, and nobody was taking much notice of her.
Mm-hmm.
She's pretty, you know, Marilyn Monroe's a pretty thing, but
yeah,
she was Norma Jean, and no one was taking much notice of her. She says now to her friend, "Watch this." And she changed the way she walked and in the way she carried herself for a moment. And the men start looking and, you know, following her like flies, so to speak. And it was a total change of demeanor and the effect on the world around, you see. So women can be two types of women. You can be a noble woman, but to be a noble woman, a whole woman does not need to throw herself out like that and sort of dress herself up like a dog's dinner, you know, and send those pheromones out, you know, psychological pheromones, you know, out into the world and draw attention to herself and puff up. See, Norma Jean would not attract and would not be so effective. She wouldn't be so famous. But Marilyn Monroe, you see, the other part of her, when the other part stepped out, then the effect is different. And I'm saying to you that if you could find a wholeness and a happiness in your life, a completeness inside yourself, see, a fulfillment that doesn't come from the world, a completeness, you won't throw yourself out like that. You won't need to. You'll send a different message automatically. And you won't have to police yourself. It'll just be, you carry yourself in such dignity that men, the wrong kind of men, will be afraid to approach you.